It's a song we learned in Zimbabwe. You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you. Sing it again.
You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
We give you all the glory.
We give you all.
Sister, this I start since I be very tender. He and his man, they take very good care of me. Then, mommy come 4-6-2. I can't be for you for long with you for take care for you. But I began to go back for Bamenda because of some other issues there. As I go back, I start sick. Mami, they say we gave a die for my hands, but now as I've been sick, I'll never be able for a good dwala. Well, Mami, you don't ever be my all and all. You are your man. You are your man. You never ever take care of me. Since I've been too tender. Until this time when I can die so. And that's something that I'll not ever forget. Well, Mami, I don't get much for talk. What can you find? What can I find? Salo, oh, the family way the other side. Salo party.
Mami Deborah, as you see, here today we know there again. She been my sister-in-law. So I don't leave Bamenda. Under all her struggle for Comberry, because she be so important in my life. Now my man, his sister. I never fit stay behind one no come bury because mama was too good. Very simple. Loves me and be love it too. So go matter for some family. Now everybody love you. But I be happy say mama and family they love me because the way I hold them too, they like my ways and they always be one my be by them. So I say I can give mommy last barrier because he don't depart, we're not gonna meet again till we two don't leave the world. So I want to thank you. We don't make me a talk because they be everybody. I just be a wife to them. So I don't know who tell you me can't talk my talk. So I be so happy for that. And would wish say mommy will give her a defeating barrier and he will go rest with the Lord. And in fact, when he go greet others where the Lord first go. He greet my late husband, he greet the junior sister, Mrs. Ancha, where the Lord first go, and her husband, and so on. All of them, they will love me and will believe in harmony. So, we'll be sorry today, say, there are no more. Now, my people in that way I married, they take care for me, and oh, they don't die. So, I'll be so sorry about it, but God, he will love them past me. So, now, root for we all. One day, all of us shall depart. So, it will be the where if they make it go fine, we will see again where we two would don't follow. My name is Abba Helen. My husband was just like a father to them. So she was calling me my father's wife, but my husband, they were first cousin with my husband. So she loves me, and my husband, in fact, is what I cannot talk and tell, because the love was so deep in them. And they've all of them have departed. And then I said farewell to them. Well, that's how the world is. All of us shall one day go. This world is not our home. So that's how we relate.
By seasons and by times, because goodness is your nature, goodness, oh God, is your character, goodness, oh God, is your mindset. Lord, we worship you this evening, even as, oh God, we gather tonight to celebrate the love of our mother. We cannot but testify that you are good. We cannot but testify that you are faithful. We cannot but testify that you have been wonderful. You have been so cool, oh God. We say hallelujah as your people gather tonight. Oh God, we gather not to bury a young, but we gather to bury an old person. One who has lived and one who has testified of your goodness. Father, we say you are good and your mercy is enduring forever. We give you praise, we give you glory, we give you all. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We adore you.
Then I heard a voice from heaven saying to me, write, blessed are dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works follow them. Our Father, we thank you for the reading of your word. The entrance of your word giveth light and understanding to the simple. I pray, Abba Father, by reason of your word tonight, let our lives, O God, receive illumination in the name of Jesus. Any darkness, oh God, that has covered your people, by reason of your word today, let light shine. In the name of Jesus, let the captive be set free. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I say amen.
Amen.
So this evening, by the grace of God, the head talk, for God talk this evening, now a question where I will ask you. I said the head talk for God talk this evening, now a question where I will ask you and you ask your neighbor. Are you prepared to enter into true rest? Help me ask your neighbor. Whether your neighbor be prepared for enter into true rest. Ask your neighbor, are you prepared to enter into true rest? Glory to God. My mama and my papa there, my brothers and my sisters, for the few number of years where I don't spend on planet Earth, I realized one thing. Say, people, they did labor. People, they did labor for say, make sure, say, make their children, they get a good life. So much so that when they don't grow old, they say they did rest for their pikin, for take care of them. And I also realized one thing. Say many people that they labor physically, mentally, that they labor. And when you were observed for life, now say after all the struggle, you go hear someone go tell you, say, I want rest. Bring me
arrest in Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said, arrest in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now you be the true rest. Pastor, I don't realize something for life. That when somebody die, whether that person be being a professional alcoholic consumer, whether that person be being a prostitute, whether that person be being an armed robber, whether that person be being a cheat, what the way I don't see as I pass through graveyard, and you see they go write the name of the person with an inscription, R-I-P, and they begin to say, rest in peace. But I want to tell us, say, rest in peace is not there for a man. Rest in peace is not there for any woman. Where you not acknowledge Jesus Christ as his Lord and his Savior. Jesus there for his Bible. According to Matthew chapter 11 verse 28, he said, come up to me, all you who labor and are heavily loaded, and I will give you rest. So the true rest is not there for any other thing. The true rest, what will you talk about? Now Jesus Christ, he will give true rest. Are you getting me, somebody? Somebody live your life anyhow. Say you be enjoy life. Nobody live your life anyhow. My brother, say you be enjoy life. Nobody live your life anyhow. Sister, say you be enjoy life. That life where you be pushing, you be enjoy. It not be the true life. That life where you think, say you can live. Not be the true life. True life and eternal life. If they in a man, and that man now the Lord Jesus Christ. Are you prepared to enter into the true rest? Ask me your neighbor again. If your neighbor be prepared to enter into true rest. Ask your neighbor. You be prepared to enter into true rest. You be that man where another person in labor. When farming season in the approach, people that in labor for seven, they get good produce. But you are always, you be wonder when that planting don't be ready. Now that time you will go put around. Bible make me to understand for the place where we read this evening. Now the apostle John the beloved, he said, I heard a voice saying, blessed is the man that died in the Lord. Blessed not be not a man where he build mansion. Blessed not be for a woman or a girl where he be work for a husband. And when that husband come, you get married to that husband and you pop begin them. Not be that one who be talk. Blessing is there not for a man. Blessing is there for a woman that died in the Lord. Because when you die in the Lord, Bible tells me, say, you will cease from your labor. Many people that be labor. For make sure so they put food on your table, it be very important. But when you don't labor throughout, and you not get in the Lord, when you die, no matter who you are, you not go rest in peace. As in scripture we always get for the graveyard, rest in peace. Bible tell us, say, it go only be a man, it go only be a woman when it die in the Lord. Because it goes cease
in labor. And the next thing what we understand or we see from this passage of scripture, Bible tells me say, their works, he go follow them. What will be your work? My brother, what will be your work? My sister, Bible make me to understand. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man sow, that he shall reap. Galatians 6:7. What will you be sown on? Now think that way you go reap. You know whatever plant cassava, you harvest cocoyam. You never ever plant plantain, you expect to harvest here. What you where you sow, now you where you go reap. What to be the kingdom where you sow? You be hear me this evening. You be that cow where you do wrong. Or don't make between their pet. They will deceive you. All in the name of you enjoy life. That is not life, my sister. You may be eating the body fish with your right hand, and you begin to drink matter with your left hand. You say you be enjoy. You may be enjoy. If Jesus not there on your side, when you die, you not go enjoy this rest where we be talk about. Your end will be eternal condemnation. But this evening, I don't come with a prayer for you. That as you hear this word today, you will decide to follow the man where he begins to rest. And that man is Jesus Christ. I said that man is Jesus Christ. Are you prepared to enter a true rest?
You are worthy to be praised.
Sing, you are Alpha and Omega.
You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
We give you all.
Yeah.
name na McDonald, that be Mami in my feet bone. Right. All everything happened like a surprise way, I know be fee be available, but I just thank God say Mami don't go for go rest. Even though he don't over suffer, me I believe say he don't go rest and I pray say play with the may so rest in perfect peace. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, what I became. I don't give it. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawn. It's time to sing Your song. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Come bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Your holy name.
agriculture. She left Ekona in 2019 to my 16 due to the social political problems in the southwest region. She took ill and was moved from one hospital to another. She was later taken to the general hospital in Douala, where she finally gave up her ghost on Friday, 5th August, at exactly 11:45 a.m. Later, Mami Deborah was a fervent Christian of the Full Gospel Church of Cameroon. She leaves behind 6 children, 6 grandchildren, a brother, sisters, cousins, friends, family, and loved ones to mourn her.
Deborah, Ebi Mari, Joe Okomo from Abanda. Joe Okomo, and Mamasa is small brother. Now me and Mamasa, we will go take him from Abanda. We bring him for Ekona. As we bring him for Ekona, as we come for Ekona, I call my farm, I give the brother. Mamasa call him on, man begin farm, give the Imasa. Mamasa go plan work for research. I put Ekona for day. I said, Papa, I come over there. We come on ourselves. What family not be only for a corner? Me and Mamasa, now he be our house for that day. Because Mamasa be training as regular. Now he can be house for help, put his papa for there. As we be for that house, he said, we don't come for my 16. He said, he will follow away again before he can find his place there for their soul. I see find the place where they for day. It can be the house. This company now may be the plan shop for day. After you. And so Mami Deborah Ekomo. Mami is Deborah Ekomo. It is the kind of woman way. Whether Papa Ekomo have a Papa Levan. Ekona na do.
No, call me the person give a talk.
This is Papa Levan. So.
Okay, good music.
Papa Ekomo won't talk anything. It's a Papa Levan. So. A big a humble woman. He followed me for full gospel. Here in Massa, all them do the following of the gospel, sorting up to death. So I thank God, say, as they be continue, but I pray the God, say, may God help, say, may their soul be rest in peace. And at the prayer, say, may another picking for this house, may follow the footsteps of Mami Deborah.
Church, we always give good report for Christ where they go bury her. But I want us to understand that God be the final say. Yes. Amen. Amen. No can see as they bury some man, then you go join church. Say me they can't bury you to find. But make sure that as you there for church, your Christian life they find before God. Amen. Amen. The record of my life will be played on that day. The record of your life will be played on that day. The things we do on earth. Our life so will be played on that day. The record of my life will be played on that day. The record of your life will be played on that day. The things we do on earth, God is recording them. So the record of our life so will be played on that day. It will be played.
We play. I want to preach on a subject What I saw this afternoon, have you believed in the Lord? That is the caption of what I want to preach. Have you believed in the Lord? And if you have believed, I would also like to encourage you to keep on going. If you have not believed, after this message, I pray that you believe in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Where we read in Job chapter 14 verse 1, it's a man who is born of a woman, is of short life, and full of many trouble. As far as life is concerned, life don't always be coupled with trouble. And many trouble come through life and take away life from people. And I want to make us to understand, as far as we are concerned, the life that we live, there is no life where we live where this life did not get trouble when it coupled to it. Let me say this. There was a family. And this family, the papa for this family, he did grow up for a background with a background, a very poor background. And as he did grow for this background, he suffered for life so much where this man, as he don't grow up for this suffer, he make the decision, he determined. He said, as he suffer, he not forever create his own pity that after he suffer, the same suffer. And this man worked very hard. After he don't work, he don't acquire so many things in life. And he get to begin. When this begin, he don't sponsor him for school. As this begin, don't he go school, he don't reach for high school. And then he promises to this man to go university out of the country. And when this man he prepared how he can go for university out of the country, then this begin, he don't get the vision. He don't ready to see himself abroad. And he not take long time during holiday period. When holiday don't come out like this, this begin on the seat. He won't realize information become saying papa don't die. And when this begin get the information saying papa don't die, he don't believe, because the papa don't give the assurance, the papa don't make many promises for him. And this begin, he look at the issue. When he can realize that true his father don't die, it was not easy. And then why the devil make arrangement for the money barrier, problem rise up, and the problem rise and say, all the thing where the man he don't work, he don't acquire, say, he can sponsor his begin there. At that same place where they make arrangement for the money barrier, that same place trouble broke. And then, this begin see, he said, all thing the way he don't say they will acquire from his father, inheritance. This begin see, he said, some uncle come on this side. They said, now he get this land. The other one come on this side. They said, now he get the house. So other one come on this side. They said, now he go get that beginning, mommy. Now he go inherit the woman. And then after a long problem, then they come to decide. They go say, okay, tradition don't talk, say, if this kind of occasion come up, the mommy and the pikin, they go come up for family house. And then they go find their way to stand back another life. And it was a great trouble. And then this pikin, he see himself from the state where he see himself for another level. And then he go out, they begin to cry. And then he begin to decide. He say, okay, I will become an armed robber. To kill all those people, when they make me, they put me for this condition. And when that begin become an armed robber, it's that he targets those people there. So he becomes for a time, when he reaches for a point, when they be catching, when they go to armed robbery, and then they catch this boy. And And then when the decamer he goes to court, now compare this story to the decam. It's not what he explained. He said, when he began small, he will be ever not say that so in life for Gabi. That now trouble he put him to that state. And that begins Yahweh in future. He see how all his ambition is crumbled within a very short time. Now what I want to make us to understand as he, as far as would he live, every life where would he live, there are troubles where he be connected to those lives. And as trouble connect to those lives, by here you realize that many die in there today. You see today, sometimes you just say, you are a young girl, you are so beautiful in a town like this. Nobody, not the way it is beautiful like you. Then you realize it. It ain't the beauty when you get up, not a trouble to you. Because any place where you go, not trouble for you because of your beauty. And you can't realize. Some people say, no, I get money. If I talk, nobody will be talking again. Then you realize it. Many of your trouble you get up as a result of money when you get up. Every life will live in this earth without Jesus. That life is a troublesome life. That's why in that place where we read from John 14, you realize that Jesus, if he make a summary, especially in this John 14 where we read, Jesus, he be with his disciples, he used the words, and before he would use these words, say, let not your heart be troubled. There was a very big trouble among them. Because why? For the previous verses, the Bible said Jesus, he put the disciples together. Is that there they say, he want to wash their feet. And then at this time, they realized that Jesus was their big man. And as far as the system of the world is concerned, now small people, they get to honor big man, especially if they talk about washing of feet. Then Jesus come, he say, he want to wash their feet. And the argument start for them. And then Jesus tell them and in another place. He said, any man who ever be big man, he must first bring himself like a small child. So that was the thing, a problem with the disciple. They never be able to understand. And then they move on again. Then the Bible says they when they reach to another state in that same chapter. The Bible says that Jesus tell his disciples them. He said, as we gather like this, somebody could betray me. The disciples they say, what? It can never happen. We know how we love ourselves. We know how we love you. And who is that person that can betray you? So at that moment, when Jesus finished for them, and then Jesus tell them again, the third thing again, he said, very soon I could die. I could live for now. And when these disciples them, many of them, they abandon so many things. They come, they dedicate all their life to follow Jesus. And then, these three important things, three important events, where it will take place for that chapter, for chapter 13, it will make way the disciples they shut up. Some they say, I would not surely be frustrated. This is the way we don't leave everything but I follow Jesus. It means that we don't surely be frustrated. And at this moment, they were so troubled. And all their heart was full of trouble. Then Jesus rose up in chapter 14, in verse 1. He said, let not your heart be troubled. He said, believe in God and also believe in me. And you realize that at this time, the only antidote of trouble is believing in Jesus. Are you getting me, somebody? Now, you realize it. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Because as we are living like this, many of us, when we should go for here, we get trouble. Some people, not only close, if you cover them, you feel they are better people. Some people, not the house where they stay inside, you cover them, you feel they are better people. As far as life is concerned, this life where would you live? Not a life where it is full of trouble. And today, I come to tell each and every one of us who will hear here today, say the only way you can live a successful life, now if your life is in Jesus, if your life is not in Jesus, your life will be a life of crisis. Your life will be a life that every day you'll be faced with one trouble, one challenge to another. Because today you realize that anything where you do for this ground, if you talk, they say you don't talk. If you not talk, they say why you not talk. If you go for some place, they say you go. You not go, they say why you not go. You married, they say, hey, this man is late. You not married, they say why he not married. Everything about life in which we engage is full of trouble. And I come to tell you, say, as far as we are living, the only responsibility that a man gets in this life is believing in Jesus. Amen. If you have not believed in Jesus, I want you to take the occasion of this moment to die. May you believe in Jesus.
World. And when we get God talk like this, and people they think I'm very light, they don't listen, they just talk, and it will wonder me, because no man will go to heaven when not prepared. You know, if you go to heaven by mistake, you will go to heaven when you prepare. And if you know reach for heaven, you know if you miss hell, you must go now for hellfire. So I pray, say, maybe God talk will not hear today, for here, make that God talk, it change our decision. It changed our lives. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Can we say a better amen?
Amen.
See, the only way of escape is that belief in the Lord Jesus. And you shall be saved. You shall be saved from trouble. This world will be inside. And you shall be saved from hell and death. You shall be saved from going to hellfire. You shall be saved from the power of sin. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Now, I want to pray for the family. I want us maybe stand up. And before I still go ahead to prayer, maybe just stand up. Can we just stand up everywhere we are? I used to talk, say, I believe they will hear pigeon for afternoon. Our papa or the Ekomo's family, now a big family. Me, so I belong to this family. Because when I been repent for 18 years of age, I been meet up na papa then. And they received me, and many of us who will be repent, like picking for us, you don't know the difference. If people don't be good for this ground, where we don't see them, this family come from a good parent. Because they spend for, you don't know who be the real picking way come for their belly. And you don't know the one way it come and come. We not get different, we not look like tribes. Different tribes they come, or the one it belong to this side. And this good work, way Papa they be do, because they be serve God. It be expected, say, not be only to stop the power of death. Way, because I look the years, so mommy here. Here, it's not supposed to be so. It never stay where we come here. And I want to talk, say, no be only the issue or stop the power of premature death. You supposed to live, you see your begin again. Because now, so God is promiser. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Not be only for stop such things, but for make say make una follow the footsteps of our father and our mother. We will born una inside the Lord, dedicate una inside church. If you na not serve that same God, I don't know whose side you will go. And I talk so because I talk as your senior brother. For all who are from Pelex to the rest. If we are not serve this great God, where they be show we and we follow, whose side will not go? Make we not take them serious. Because life without Christ is destruction. Leave any other thing. Serve Jesus. So that the blessings of the Lord, where your father and your mother our father and our mother, there be no already pile up in God where they will follow their children, make it follow on. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Can we say a better amen?
Amen.
I take this very serious. Some of you may not know the God of us here. This is already wrong. We don't wrong a gray hair. A white face too. Like my good elder, the Lord is not this one. You know, they say, they're going to hate, they're going to turn. That is how they turn. My own turn for us. Yes, now they bring me up in the Lord. We say amen.
Amen.
And I judge them, all of them, and I judge. You know, that they bring me. Now you teach me. You got to go baptize. And I judge. I mean, judge. I repeat. For go baptize, 1988, Christmas Day, and inside the same toilet. Then they ask you say fornication, and which thing? Where I want to go baptize? He says, if this will not go sleep woman until you married. I said, eh? Then I said, if that one, me that one better go. I don't give my life for Jesus. So he was the one who taught me that. And that just go. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So when I serve the Lord, shall we pray? Father, we give you thanks. We give you praise. We honor you for your goodness and your faithfulness. We thank you because it has pleased you this day that we will pray for this family. The end of every man's life is in you. Your word says the days of man are short, but they are full of trouble. But you are able to change our testimony as we come to know you as the living God, as the one who holds our future. Even as you are servant Job said, I know my Redeemer lives. I know he shall keep me in the day of trouble. Therefore, I pray, O God, bring in this great family into your hands. That God of heaven, you will protect and keep everyone. Save from harm. Save from trouble. Save from sickness. Save from premature death. Save from troubles. In the name of Jesus, we pray, O glorious King, that your hand shall rest upon each one of them. Give them good success in this world. Give them breakthrough in this world. In the name of Jesus, above all, draw everyone to serve the living God, to follow the way of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father, we eliminate the power of premature death from this family. In the name of Jesus,
amen.
We pray that God, we shall not be gathered here to bury anyone, but we shall gather for good news. In the name of Jesus,
amen.
For marriages, for breakthrough,
yes.
For celebrations,
yes.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
Be glorified, O God. Be praised forever. In Jesus' name we are praying.
On behalf of the Ekomo family, the grandkids, the Ancha family, and myself, and the family seated here, we just want to say thank you for sharing this time and this moment with us. We appreciate your presence. If I have to rewind back, there are so many people here that I haven't seen for maybe 20 years or more. But when I first came to the corner, Mami came to Bamenda when she saw me. I was so stubborn. She sat there and looked at me. I would not do the dishes. I won't do anything. They cook and I eat and I disappear. And then she looked and she said to my mom, she said, I'll take her with me. And when she took me, I was excited to meet Bamenda. So when she brought me in the neurology, there's a little detail I put in there. I remember the first day she took me to the kitchen and she said I should boil rice. So when I went into the kitchen, the rice was already ready. I took fufu stick and I stirred the rice and stirred it. And then when she came in, she looked at it, she screamed. She said, oh, my mommy became it, and she was crying. And I looked at her. And then she started laughing. And then she hugged me. She said, don't worry, my momo, I will teach you everything. I will teach you how to cook. And from that day, I was always by her side. As Pastor said, in that house, we don't know the biological children, and we don't know the adopted, and we don't know any. When I cook, I put pot on the ground. Whoever is in the house, we dish the food and eat. The moment the food is finished, I go back to the kitchen to cook some more. And I enjoyed it because she taught me that. And today, that's what I'm practicing in my house because of her. But the most important thing is that I receive Christ through her. And I call Full Gospel Church Ekona people, family, my generals. Because today, I'm going all over the world to preach the gospel. But this is my foundation. And so I want to say thank you. And thank you for the word that you have given to my sisters and brothers, and I also thank you for reminding us that, hey, they have to make a decision for them. And it's time. If I have to fast forward, whatever advice I can give you guys is that people think it's not real. But I want to tell you that Jesus is real and Christ is coming soon. And the first thing you should ask yourself is, will he meet you at the right place? Will you be the five virgin girls who are white and ready? Or will you be the ones that will walk and at the end you will not be able to enter? So I want to encourage you, make a decision for Christ. Because it's coming soon. It's not a story. It's real. I'm coming from the Western world where there are so many things that have been fulfilled. A lot of things have been put in place. It's like they are trying to run faster than God. But they cannot because the word of God is so true and it must come to pass. So I'm encouraging you people. Thank you all for coming. May God bless you. And after this, there will be refreshment. And we will direct people in different groups on how we can feast and celebrate with you. Thank you very much.
Mami Magi, if you come, you can go meet your pastor from our 16. If you explain to the pastor from our 16, who oh, Mami Deborah Ekomo? Who will not be? Kwekuna? The years we don't serve God. Every up to this time, it can't be for this serious sick. I can't go because the pastor from our 16, they take them very serious. That pastor is a man of God. If they take them serious, and as they follow up, even after they take my amigo ball. For my lady, if you follow up, the same thing that he said, go, they pray for my lady. And if they can't check in, they can't check in. I want to talk to say, Mami Deborah, you die. You know me now. But from still when, I want to talk to say, we are keep somebody or some. We have our days. Any man get a day. The believers, I want to tell you an experience of this guy. For say, we will take care. Because when Jesus be the toxin, he be the sick, you know, you see me. Sometimes when I tell that scripture, when you're sick, you know, this city, believers, they will be very vigilant. When we go to church, when they will chop now, 1,000 members, Jesus with all your heart. I thank God for Mami Deborah. Even through 20 pastors, now Pastor Sebastian, this my begin, my begin. All other pastors, Pastor Columbus, together with my here. If the servant of God, he don't go outside. Pastor Sebastian, one will not be here. Pastor Makolo, another from here. Those pastors where they passed through Ekona, all of them, they get the testimony to give them for this money. At the time, God, because I am a servant of God, I don't carry my sister go for any man above. I don't go for any Ngabi man for find out where did it happen. For say, your husband don't die 1 year, he began that. I know say, he be appointed for you for this time. My own appointment. So I don't get much to talk.
Okay. Amen. As our pastor, the assistant pastor for my 16, one church to pray and sanctify this grace, so that it shall serve the purpose for which it may be intended.
Let us pray. Father, thank you. We give you glory for the life of our mother. Father, she is about to engage in herself into that final journey. And here is the grave that has been prepared for her. We decree and declare that this grave is sanctified, is blessed to serve the purpose of burial in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. In the book of Job, chapter 14, verse 14, Job be asked a question. Say, if man die, that man he go live again. And he say, me I go wait for all my life, because my change it go come. For Message Bible, he say, I will wait for the day of my resurrection. Job, he been talk this talk because in those days, he been be the richest man. And not only that, he been get good children and good family. He been live good life. But for one day, all your world, if you go, children, they go. And not be only that, but the devil, if he put wounds and boils for his body. Until his wife, he look at it, he say, a dead person, he did the same like you. So you better curse God so that you die. Because his body, if he don't rot it. And when you look at the body, you ask, say, life, he come again. And the Bible goes ahead for talk, say, if man die like this, if he live again, he say, me, I go wait, because change or resurrection, he go come. And one for talk, say, Jesus did make a statement. He say, any man where he believe in me, he no go die. Even if he die, he go live again. Can we say amen?
Amen.
And he talks in, a day is coming when the trumpet of the Lord it will sound. And those where they don't die in Christ, they go hear. And when they hear, they go live. they will come out from this grave. They will come out from their grave. And nothing will be able to hinder them. And they will meet Jesus in the air. And those of us who will still believe in Christ, we will also be caught up together in the air. We'll meet them, and we'll meet with the Lord Jesus. And the Bible says, forever and ever we shall live with him. Amen. And we say amen.
Amen.
That will be the greatest hope when we get for this ground. So as we delay Mami for here, a day is coming when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and she will rise up again.
Amen.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
So prepare your own life for that great day. But if you not believe in Christ, you not will hear that trumpet. The one way you go hear, not the one for come for your judgment and for go to hellfire. May that one not be our portion.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I will ask, make them take the casket down immediately. As it has pleased God to take our mother, our sister, Mami Deborah Ekomo, out of this world, we now commit her body to the earth to await the day of resurrection. Earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. But God shall raise up your body again, as the scripture declares, that the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God and shall come forth from their graves. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
As the Lord Jesus died and rose from the dead, so your body shall also rise on the day of resurrection. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Glorious King, we give you glory. As Lord, you wash over the body of Moses, so shall you wash over the body of your daughter, your servant. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No one shall be able to use this environment, this grave, for any ritual. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord God of Israel, no one shall be able to use our image for ill God to frighten anybody. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray, O glorious King, sealing this environment with the blood of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus.
May your name be honored. May your name be glorified. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, I worship your holy name. Your holy name.
And second to the last born of Mami Deborah Ekomo. Well, it's quite unfortunate. What has happened has happened. God gave reason for anything it happened. I mean, don't die fine. Be very grateful for any man who come around. Yeah, thank all man who come around. Yeah. The place, as Mami don't go, she was very kind to us. She was a one and only mother to us. She was very good to us. Yeah. But thank God for what has happened. Yeah. So what I have to say is that she should stay well. She should one spirit and look after us. God should help so that everything to God. Just okay. Yeah. Thank you for understanding. Yeah. So,
my name's Atre George Ekongo. I'll be an uncle to this Mami Deborah Ekomo who celebrate he died today. I want to really thank those who have contributed financially, materially, in prayers, and in many ways. Especially those of our brothers and sisters who live in the diaspora. They have played to us a very great role. And I think say, if we talk about love, this one they really show say, now love with this. I want to talk to this our sister to be a very good woman. Even though as human being, man is a good all, now God good past all. So if you be a good woman, and even a husband also will be a good husband, maybe they welcome people of all kinds. Even me personally, when I be enter for a corner, this is my sister, anytime I come to her house, if chop no day must enter some place, they make sure that me I chop something. And so this one make them will get joy and will get happiness. For sister, we will celebrate the day. No matter which way it will cost us, or no matter what it will take us for do. And I believe that anybody will not cheap in anything. Now because of the good hard way this woman will get them. And the husband will be welcome every man for family. They don't care whether this one will be who or this one will be who. And I make her say they die, they pass in a successful way. So I want to advise the family, say, make they take the same spirit where especially the children, where their parents, the mommy and the husband, if they get them, where they will love everybody and they will be so kind to everybody. And because of their good works, they feel for see a wonderful defeated barriers where they are here for these two couples. So my advice to the family must be say, make the beginning, maybe they be united. Because I see a lot of war and a lot of strife where it is amongst them. And I want to still call on this family where they don't support this woman. They say, make them come so that we will bring down these children and we gather them and we talk with them so that they will live in unity, not in striving as around the team. So I want to thank everybody so much for all the things where they are doing for this, our sister, for sister, we fit forget a defeated barrier. And above all, we thank God. Because God is the highest. And really this woman was a God-fearing woman. And we feel foresee the fruit of serving God. So I call on everybody, say, if you never know Jesus, give your life to Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. When time reaches, time of problems, you will see many people will come out. Jesus will take control. So thank you very much. And may God bless everyone will come here, and God will take us back safely in Jesus' name.
Yes, Abi Mami is first between Lawrence. Today for grief side for Mami, I've been happy for what you put on campus. You will help me today. We will join together very Mami, like a mother. As you know, Mami done is sick for almost 2 years now. So as a Christian mother, God don't last call you for rest. So thank God for today, we thank God for life, we thank God for everybody that come here, and we praise Him. As God bring everyone here safely, and so all will go back safely. So I thank everybody who don't be here for today. I thank every and everyone. It's not easy, but I say with God, all things are possible. Just a short message answer for everybody here today. Thank you very much. And God will replenish any person who doesn't support me morally, financially, send me Mami burial, go on fine. And everything will pass as planned. Thank you guys.
Charge. Yeah. And if we have to come in for anything, we have to pass through them.
Yeah. Okay.